25-year-old Shakira Atuhaire, a resident of Matuga, has been taking tuberculosis medication for 2 months. Shakira, who thought she had no more cough, began coughing blood for more than 2 weeks. She narrates how she got to know that she had tuberculosis.
I coughed for 2 months, but I didn't think it was a serious condition. I used to get and pick locks drugs over the counter. But after some time, I started to cough blood. That's when I went to Mulago Hospital and I was told I had tuberculosis.
She will be well in a period she's not aware of. Dr. Ojambo Flavia, a medical officer at the National Medical Tuberculosis Unit, says many patients are like Shakira because they cough for more than 2 weeks and think it's just a normal cough. Treatment of tuberculosis has a lot of barriers and challenges. Dr. Flavia explains the most common barriers that need attention.
The barriers of TB treatment cut across. One of the first things I would talk about is so many things affect patients, especially coming for treatment. One is that some don't even know what TB is. Some do not know information. They have limited knowledge about TB. They will have symptoms for a while and they will be sick. They come in when they are sick for over 8 months. And they have visited all other alternative sources of medicines and other health centers until they are not fine anymore. Then they will think about tuberculosis. So I would say there is a knowledge gap in us, the community. The community doesn't know where to access TB treatment from. So TB is always attached to HIV. The other misconception everyone has is that only HIV patients get tuberculosis. However, everyone is at risk of having tuberculosis. HIV just increases your risk of having tuberculosis. So like any drug, TB drugs also have their side effects. And since we take them for quite a number of months, they also have, the side effects can be very severe at times.
Dr. Flavia explains that different types of tuberculosis one should be aware of.
Drug-resistant TB is when the TB germ continues to grow. Even in presence of those first-line drugs, it will still continue to grow. That means that the drugs are not working on that TB germ. So that means we have to now go to a second line of defense, which we call the second-line drugs. Okay? So that one, it according, like I said, they can be for 9 months, they can be for 11 months, and they can be for 18 months. There is guidance according to our national program who is able to receive which length of treatment.
Research done by the Union to Access Tuberculosis Preventive Treatment in Uganda is aimed at exploring how tuberculosis preventive treatment can be improved for people living with HIV, including children, as John Paul Dongo explains.
This study is being implemented at 12 health facilities across 8 districts in Uganda. These are Hoima, Kakumiro, Mitiana, Wakiso, Kalungu, Masaka, and Chotara districts. The study aims to generate programmatic evidence to identify and strengthen approaches to improve TB preventive treatment, initiation, adherence, and completion, with a focus on people living with HIV in Uganda. And I should mention that at the inception of this study, a number of activities were carried out. These were really mainly training of healthcare workers on programmatic management of latent TB infection, training healthcare workers on the rationale of TB preventive treatment and determining eligibility of TB preventive treatment, determining the dosing and duration of TB preventive treatment, but also supporting our healthcare workers to be able to manage common side effects and adverse events associated with TB preventive treatment.
Dr. Tria Hawestavia, the Commissioner for Tuberculosis and Leprosy from the Ministry of Health, says tuberculosis kills 30 Ugandans daily. She explains how we are standing as a country.
So our current estimate for tuberculosis stands at 91,000 Ugandans falling ill with TB disease every year. That's according to the Global TB Estimates report of 2022. And among these patients, about 15 or so percent are expected to be children, and about 1,500 are people who have the drug-resistant TB type. Now, when you translate that figure into smaller portions, it comes to about 200 and close to 250 Ugandans falling ill with TB disease daily.
Dr. Stavia explains how tuberculosis is spreading at a very fast rate and urges Ugandans to be on the lookout.
Let me first make it clear that tuberculosis, whether drug-resistant or drug-sensitive or susceptible TB, is curable. TB is preventable. Now, the drug-resistant TB or the susceptible TB, the most common form, is the TB of the lungs. And when people get it, the most common symptom they will get is a cough. But you can have other symptoms, or you can have no cough in case the TB is not in the lungs, because TB can affect you in any other part of the body.
According to the World Health Organization, a total of 1.6 million people died from tuberculosis in 2021, including 187,000 people with HIV. Worldwide, tuberculosis is the 13th leading cause of death and the second leading infectious killer after COVID-19, above HIV and AIDS. Report compiled by John Musenze for the news.